Manual transmission is widely used in all transport vehicles. It's used to increase and decrease speed of the vehicle and climb in slope path or mountain. Today we are going to see about structure and working principle of manual transmission gears. Manual transmission is included number of gears depend on ratio. These gears are designed based on constant mesh. Basically there are two different types of gears. One is sliding mesh gears and another one is constant mesh gears. In ancient days sliding mesh gears were used in vehicles. The sliding mesh gear teeth are always straight. We can use these gears as sliding mechanism to change from one gear to another. But it will create more friction, noise and complexity. After a few years constant mesh gears have introduced. These teeth are inclined at specific angle. We can't use this as sliding mechanism because it is always constant. Let's see some basic parts of manual transmission. They are synchronizer cone, synchronizer ring, hub, sleeve, and shaft. Hub is fixed with shaft. Sleeve will rotate with hub, on the other hand it will act as sliding mechanism. Sleeve connects shaft and gear. During gear change, friction will be occurred. To reduce friction, synchronizer ring is used. The ring is connected to rotate independently. This will reduce friction and make gear transmission as smooth. In gear structure there are three different types of shafts. They are input shaft, counter shaft and output shaft. Input shaft is transmitting engine rotation to counter shaft and counter shaft is transmitting to output shaft. Output shaft is connected with wheels through drive shaft. As a result, wheels are rotating depend on gear's transmission. These rotational motion transfers among gears. The counter shaft gears are fixed with shaft and output gears are loosely connected. Output gears will rotate with shaft while sleeve transfer to particular gear. Each and every time we try to change gear, we should press clutch pedal. Clutch is acting as connector between engine shaft and input shaft. When we press the clutch, connection between engine and input shaft will be disengaged and we can change from one gear to another smoothly. In fifth gear, output shaft gear is fixed with shaft and counter shaft gear is connected loosely, because here reverse gear comes. The reverse gear is required one gear additionally, which is known as ideal gear. The ideal gear will rotate with counter shaft gear and ideal gear will turn output gear in opposite direction to drive the vehicle in reverse direction. The type of reverse gears are designed depend upon sliding mesh. The reverse gears don't have any synchronizer cone and ring. To transmit gear to reverse gear, vehicle should stop completely before change, otherwise gearbox will damage. The sleeve is connected with gear shift lever through shift rod. At first gear, 4 or 5 revaluation of counter gear is equal to 1 revaluation of output gear. If we increase gear, it will be increase inversely proportional to counter shaft gear. For example, at 5th gear, 1 revaluation of counter shaft gear is equal to 4 or 5 revaluation of output gear. Note, this transmission which as explained in video will not applicable for 2-wheelers.